behind the frame shop and taken the picture out of the aluminum molding, and I left the magic molding on. What I've done is I've put some gold all around the edge because I've got a wood frame already made for it, but the wood frame is a lot thinner. The lip on this wood frame is only a quarter of an inch, whereas on the other one it was well over a half inch. So there's going to be a lot of the molding, magic molding, sticking out. I thought I would change the appearance of it and just make it gold so it looked like two different frames or a frame within a frame instead of just plain. Now this is a real tight fit. I have this, I haven't cut this frame. Let us go in. This is a real tight fit. Next time, should have been a 16th of an inch wider. That's okay. It does fit in. Fits in nice and snug. And there we are.
This is our magic molding.
This is our wooden frame. Now, the reason I haven't done a lot of wooden frames is because of these. And the way wooden frames are put together, you take this and you shoot it. Now this little device is made by Fletcher Carey, and it shoots a little rad in that you can actually pry out. But the main thing is that when it shoots, it'll go through whatever it's running into. Some will use something like an air gun that shoots, but it's shooting most of the backs of conventional frames. They use cardboard on the back, so this works for them because they shoot through the cardboard and into the frame molding. But with magic molding, you don't want to shoot through at an angle. It has to be straight in. So there. So now this won't come out. It's in solidly. To finish this off, unlike standard molding, most wood frames, they put they put craft paper on the back. But we don't want craft paper either. We're going to put a piece of Mylar on the back of it. So what I'm doing here, putting on double stick adhesive. Adhesive will allow the Mylar or craft paper, whichever one has used, stick to the wood of the mold. So now all I have to do is, all I'm going to do is strap that on there like that. Doesn't really matter. Just down and dirty today. And we're going to cut this out just like we would with a piece of craft paper. There we are. Now all we need to do is put the screw eyes in here and a wire for hanging, and we're all done. And so now we can use the Noah's Ark system with wood frame moldings, just like I've always wanted. The only thing we needed was magic molding to make it all possible. So that.